Welcome, everyone, to the NBA on 2K Sports. With Greg Anthony and Hall of Famer Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan. And joining us on the sidelines, another Hall of Famer, David Aldridge. A moment now to look at the year-to-year scoring output and how it has been trending for Mike Conley.
And maybe it's shocking, maybe not too shocking, but the scoring trend over the last few years has been going down a bit. I'm sure it's something he's well aware of, and we'll see if that continues to be the case.
And checking out Minnesota's opening lineup, the two towering figures inside for him, Towns and Gobert. Conley is the point, Edwards plays on the wing, and it's McDaniels in at the three spot. And for the Mavericks, Seth Curry is out there with Doncic. Then it's Jones. Then there's Grant Williams. And it's Lively in at the center, locking down the middle. Early in the season, there are always some surprises, Greg. It goes to show you how impossible the NBA season is to actually predict.
And you never know what's going to happen, Kevin, until the game starts. Some teams look good and flop out of the gates. Other teams take giant leaps forward.
When you think of Seth Curry, you're thinking shooting, but there, what a pretty pass to find the open man.
Outside, Edwards. Towns, wide open. Mavericks with the rebound. Their last game, a win against the Lakers, looking to carry it into this one.
Yeah, in that game, I thought they took advantage of some sloppy play, but give them credit. They turned mistakes in the points.
Well, you have to capitalize when your opponent has miscues and give this team some credit. Every time that opponent turned it over, they capitalized.
Near the three-point line, it's Edwards. It's good, only a few seconds into the shot clock.
Well, in pick-and-roll action, Anthony Edwards is thinking score first. Good decision right there.
And there's the call on Rudy Gobert. That is his first foul of the game. Lively, the pass to Kerr. Doncic against Conley. Curry with a wide open look. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. Doris, lots of people are excited to see how this Timberwolves team progresses.
Certainly, Kevin, you have to admire what Anthony Edwards showed you in terms of those exciting young players. He proved he was more than capable of elevating his responsibility. And when you think about their postseason, you ran into Nikola Jokic and the eventual champs. You can live with that.
And here is Doncic after Anthony Edwards made that last three-pointer. Basket counts.
If you allow Luka to establish position because of his size, his strength, his footwork, turn the lights out.
Towns, a screen on Doncic. Conley inside the line, and there are the Timberwolves with another bucket. And so here is Dallas. They trail by one. Now here's Jones. McDaniels defending. Pass to Curry. Jones sets the pick for Curry. Looking for McDaniels. He gets it there. And here's Edwards from the arc. Sinks the three-pointer. Edwards got a couple of threes now in the first with the Timberwolves. And there's the pass to Lively. Dallas moving it around. Doncic passes to Lively. The Mavericks shooting their first free throws tonight. The first trip to the stripe in this one.
Shooting two.
He's off on the first. Doris, when we look at the Dallas Mavericks, it looks like a team that has shown they want to win now.
Kevin, I think their ownership has never been afraid to pull the trigger on a big trade. The Mavs are not about just making it to the playoffs. This is an organization that seeks the ultimate prize, and that is to win an NBA championship.
And the second free throw, good. First quarter of play, we're about 3 minutes in. Gobert with a screen on Doncic. Oh, the lob to Gobert. Throws down the alley-oop slam.
Well, the seven-footer Gobert, the alley-oop finish. My goodness, the stifled tower with the score.
Mavericks trail by five. Now, Doncic. He picked up 33 points in their last win against the Lakers.
And you know, guys, the other thing I really appreciated about his effort in that game was the effort and work on the glass. What a well-rounded performance.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
I think defensively, that is not the way you want to start. Giving up high percentage looks, that doesn't typically end well.
1:29 left to play in the first quarter. Outside Edwards. Towns sets the pick for Edwards. Count the bucket, and he's got a free throw coming up as well.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks.
Minnesota shooting their first foul shot of the night.
And really, the form at the line all season has been terrific. 79% as a team.
Catching up on the changes for Dallas. Hardaway's checked in for Williams. Hardy comes in for Curry, and it's Exum in for Doncic.
Well, you love watching Karl-Anthony Towns play, guys, because this is an offensively gifted big man. Can shoot with range. You can put him in the post, let him work back to the basket. He can put the ball on the floor. A lot to love on the offensive end.
Now here is Hardaway. Against the Lakers, he was really on his game. 102 left in the first quarter of the game. Anderson passes to Milton. Now Gobert. Outside, Towns. The kick out to Anderson. Second chance shot, and that one drops.
They've wasted no time settling into their offense.
Passes it to Jones. Inside, here's Lively. Pass to Hardy. Just four to shoot. Takes the 13-footer. Rudy Gobert with the rebound. And now the fast break. Anderson with the ball. And the dunk by Towns.
And what a way to start this game, dominating at both ends of the floor.
And give them credit for approaching this game with the right energy and intensity. This team has attacked every chance they've gotten. Well, there's an unpredictability to his offensive game. He is always keeping the defense off balance.
And so it's the Minnesota Timberwolves bringing the quarter to a close with a 7-point lead. They're shooting the ball so well in this one. A great performance from the field. And we've got more M2K Sports coming your way after this break. And thanks again for tuning in. If you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter of action so far. And a chance to catch up on some numbers here, the scoring breakdown for the Timberwolves.
And guys, I love the movement, doing a great job of just getting the ball on a string, creating some opportunities.
And they've also shown dominance in the paint so far tonight, really putting the work in down low.
Timberwolves leading by seven. Well, here we are talking about Timberwolf greats. One player standing out to me, and Doris, I know to you, that's Kevin Garnett.
I don't think there is any debate that KG is number one. He is Minnesota's all-time leader in points, assists, rebounds, steals, and blocks. My goodness, what a career.
We've got Luka Doncic. Dwight Powell is out there with Morris. Then there's Harden, and it's Hardaway in at the three spot. So that's who Dallas starts the second with.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And so Doncic will bring it up for Dallas. A moment now to hear from our sideline reporter, Hall of Famer David Aldridge. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, Rudy Gobert is a fierce competitor. He says the average fan might not understand what I bring to the table, but the GMs in the league do. I want to be the best defensive player of all time. I want to be a force, and I want to win championships. I've got to set the tone every night. Kevin?
And he does. He is a stopper, no doubt about it. David, thank you. Here is Edwards after Luka Doncic's bucket. To the middle. Reed with it. Powell's there. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. Greg, there's been a scoring surge throughout the league. Is that due to poor defense, or is it to the rising talent level?
Listen, teams are still defending, and the rules might have helped some. There is no doubt that there's not as much grabbing and holding. But these guys are scoring from all over the court and doing things we've just never seen before.
And he makes the first. Williams, he's checked in for Dallas. Curry comes in for Hardy. McDaniels, he's checked in for the Timberwolves. Conley now comes in for Shake Milton. Both free throws good from Reed. And we play just over a minute of basketball here in the second quarter. Doncic passes to Curry. Good. And the assist goes to Doncic.
I think he's adding more toughness to his game. And it's great to see Seth Curry stick with it and finish strong.
Here is Edwards. 8 points for him. To the left wing. Conley against Curry. Conley kicks to Edwards. Out of bounds. Dallas takes possession. And when it comes to Luka Doncic, he's simply, Greg, one of the best players in the entire game.
No question about it. He's a threat to record a triple-double every time he takes the floor. As versatile and dangerous a player as there is in our league.
Doncic, no good. Timberwolves leading by 7. Conley scanning the floor. Oh, that's blocked.
Beautiful defense from Powell. Uses that impressive length to come away with that rejection.
Curry is inside. Covered by Conley. Knocks it loose. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Hardaway. And here's a look at some numbers for Luka Doncic.
And right now, he's in one of those grooves where he has a tremendous feel for the game. His assist numbers these past 5 look a lot different than from the rest of the season. And by different, I mean better.
Rudy Gobert is checked in for Reed. Minnesota with the ball. They've led by as much as 10. Conley dishes to Edwards. Gobert, the screen. Edwards passes to Gobert. It's blocked. And that's out of bounds. Minnesota will retain possession. And for those of you just joining us, we're almost 2.5 minutes into the second quarter.
Well, this is the kind of effort you want to see from Luka Doncic. We know how good he is offensively. Right there playing solid D.
To the inside. Lively's shot is off.
Boy, if you're going up against this guy in this close a range, you've got to defend with everything you've got. A tremendous job defensively.
Anderson can't get it to go.
Well, we didn't see the same kind of control we're used to seeing from him. This guy is usually a tremendous finisher. Such a reliable threat from range. You'd think the defense might key on him a little bit more.
Here is Edwards. He's got 8. Gobert with a screen for Edwards. Fires from deep. It's rebounded by Dallas.
He has that confidence rolling, hitting two threes in the first, but he hasn't had one since.
It's in there. Conley with the assist. Conley's got his third assist on the night.
Boy, what a good-looking stroke. Ready on the catch, Anthony Edwards. That jumper is nice.
And Dallas calls their first timeout of the game. Jones checked in for Doncic, and then for Minnesota. Towns, he's checked in for Anderson, and it's Shake Milton in for Edwards. And a little under 3.5 minutes elapsed in the second quarter of play. Curry passes to Williams. Jones with the screen on Towns. Hardaway kicks to Williams. Some nice passing here by Dallas. Five to shoot. Here's Wively. And that comes off the assist by Jones.
Boy, what great body control you saw there, laying it up and in despite having the defense draped all over him.
And the Timberwolves with possession here. Defeated by the Pelicans in their last game, they'll try to put that one behind them.
And sometimes you can make a few plays here and there, but never get into a real rhythm. That's what happened to them in that game.
I'll tell you, that's a great way to put it, because I thought they were all over the place. They never settled into any kind of rhythm.
And they've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball in the paint.
Conley against Kerr. He kicks it to Hardaway. Floats one. Milton grabs the board. And Milton's got the ball here for Minnesota. They lead by 7. Pass to Gobert. Milton looking around. Dishes to Towns. Shoots the 3. They grab their own miss. Oh, and the jam by Towns.
Wow, the size and speed of Towns. A natural born highlight reel.
Hardaway with it. Lets it go with a 3. And he beats the buzzer. Wow!
Yeah, that's just an amazing play to get that ball off in time.
Great awareness in crucial situations. Nicely done.
And so it's Minnesota with their lead standing at 6 points here at the end of the quarter. They've played the better game so far, but their work is far from over. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much, Carl. Impressive start for you. What's the mentality going into a game like this?
Just being aggressive. Really played well at all the first half myself. All of us are missing a lot of easy bunnies. We're missing layups for us as pros. So second half, if we make those layups, we should be fine.
and see if you stick to the script. Thanks very much, man. Back to you.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of action following halftime. Hey folks, welcome to the Halftime Show. A lead right now in this one for the Minnesota Timberwolves.
So far, they're being the more physical team on the boards. They've got that grit, that grind mentality, the kind of stuff coaches love to see.
What I like, it's the style of play you can be consistent with. Even when shots are going down for you, you can keep the pace.
And let's take a glance at what lies ahead, a look at the upcoming schedule.
And looking at the Trailblazers matchup, they're the much better team on paper and on the court. The biggest threat to them, they don't play down to the competition right now.
Yeah, we see that happen in this league almost on a nightly basis. Thanks for spending halftime with us. Time to get it back out to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third quarter.
And in that first half, we saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during the half. You have to like what we're seeing from Anthony Edwards.
Man, he's been running wild on them through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
Boy, he has been shouldering the load. Aggressive, skilled, talented, and thus far, unstoppable.
And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been fairly even so far. Timberwolves leading by six. And so in the game for the Timberwolves, Towns and Gobert hold down the post for him. The wing set for him, Edwards and McDaniel. And it's Conley in at the point. Dallas has gone 3-6 tonight when they let it fly from downtown. Doncic against Conley. Doncic gets it to go inside.
We know that Luke is a three-level scorer. He's elite from any range. That time he goes to the midi.
There's the pass to Gobert. Towns down low. He's against Williams. Towns gets to Conley. Pass to Gobert. Nice ball movement by Minnesota. Edwards with it. Jones covering. Edwards passes to McDaniels. Cranes it from beyond the arc.
Well, Anthony Edwards plays with joy, and you love to see him get his teammates involved. Pretty pass.
And Doris, here we're looking at Jaden McDaniels' stats. He's clearly been stepping up his game.
He has, Kevin. It's always fun to see a young talent develop their skill set, build real confidence, and Jaden's starting to carve out his space in this league.
Here's Curry with the three, rebounded by the Timberwolves. They've led by as much as 10.
Another rebound hauled in. They're hitting the glass with a lot of passion.
Getting the latest now from our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. David, it's all yours. Take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. The Timberwolves have gone Twin Towers with Karl Anthony Towns and Rudy Gobert. Gobert says, I love playing with another dominant big because I've always thought that I could pass. I know that I can make guys around me better. Pat says, we complement each other. He's a generational talent on defense, and I think I'm a generational talent on offense. Kevin, I'm a generational talent on sideline reporting.
You are indeed, and that's why you are in Springfield. No argument here, David. Thank you. Here's Conley after Luka Doncic's bucket. And slam dunk by Gobert.
Well, Mike Conley specializes in reading the floor. This guy is an expert in pick and roll.
Mavericks trail by 9. Curry finds Williams. A little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the third. Doncic passes to Williams. He dishes it to Kerr. Clock is at 3. Over Edwards. Rebounded by the Timberwolves. Towns has got 4 rebounds now tonight. Here's McDaniels. That's in there. Conley with the assist. Conley's got 6 assists in the game.
And they've had assists now on their last 3 baskets.
Here's Curry. Pass to Lively. Conley against Doncic. The fadeaway. Rudy Gobert with the rebound. Gobert's got his 6th rebound on the night. Conley kicks to Edwards. Driving inside. Can't cash in from close range. And so it's Jones. He'll bring it up for the Dallas Mavericks. 11-point game. Doncic looking it over. Outside Curry. Jones sets the pick for Curry. Shot from 12. Good. He hits the jump shot. Curry's got his 2nd bucket of the game to go.
This guy doesn't need a whole lot of space, right? Seth Curry's so good at finding his window as a pick-and-roll basketball player.
Timeout called. First of the game for Minnesota. Dwight Powell's checked in for the Mavericks. Hardaway comes in for Luka Doncic. Minnesota also making some changes. Reed comes in for Rudy Gobert. And it's Anderson in for Edwards. We've got 1:28 left in the third quarter. Pass to Reed. Towns with it. Towns is double. Reed with it. Powell's there. 2 free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. He's gone 2 for 2 at the line so far.
Shooting 2.
That free throw, no good. A different look for Dallas. Hardy comes in for Grant Williams. And it's Exum in for Curry. Alexander Walker, he's checked in for Minnesota. Shake Milton comes in for Michael Conley. And he's good on the second. 1:12 left to play in the third. Exum deciding where to go with it. And the pass to Jones. Back to Exum. Power with a screen on Milton. Offensive rebound. Tries again. Count that one. And the Timberwolves lead has been cut down to just 8 points on the bucket from Powell.
And so far, going for more of an inside presence here in the second half, getting away from the three-point shot.
Now here's Towns. 9 points in the game so far. Passes it to Milton. Hardaway against Anderson. Powell pulls it in. Dallas has gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Hardy passes to Hardaway. With a screen on Anderson. Hardaway with a wide open look. It's good from long range. And now just a 5-point Timberwolves lead. And we've reached the end of the third. Timberwolves lead by 5. We're back after this from American Airlines Center. And it's time now to bring you our State Farm assist of the game.
And he sliced the D wide open with this feed. They had no chance to prevent that basket.
Well, that's what a great pass will do, right? You love the unselfish play.
And with these teams locked in a very close contest, this fourth quarter promises to be a good one. On out there with Dwight Powell. Then there's Doncic. Then there's Tim Hardaway Jr. And it's Hardy in at the two guard. That's the lineup in the game for Dallas. And there's the call. It's going to be an illegal screen.
When a pick like that is questionable and creates that much of an advantage for the offense, you have to blow the whistle.
I don't think there's any question. There are so many rules that favor the offense these days. You've got to be able to equal things out when an illegal screen is set.
Pass to Alexander Walker. Outside, Edwards launches it. That's the sixth make from the field. He's taken 9 shots and missed but 3.
The work that Anthony Edwards is putting in as a shooter is there. That range shot, so important. Nice 3-point look right there.
And that one's good. Doncic.
Coming off a big game, his confidence couldn't be higher, and coach knows it.
Well, the best players, to me, deliver night after night after night. So as long as he's hot, keep riding it.
Here's Edwards, and finished off by Edwards.
Oh, give me a little sauce, Anthony Edwards. Rise high and finish over the defender.
Awesome display of athleticism captured by your AT&T 5G Slam Cam. Mavericks trail by 8. Doncic left side. It's stolen by Milton. And now the fast break. Anderson with the ball. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line. It's on Luka Doncic.
Really the right play defensively. If you can't block, force him to the line.
And a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for Minnesota.
They're looking to attack in transition every time down the floor, just wearing the defense thin at this point.
I think one of the things that also strikes me is their activity, forcing turnovers, coming up with steals. It has really shaped the tenor of this game.
And the first one drops, and the Timberwolves making a change here. Gobert's checked in. Both shots good from the stripe. About a minute and a half into the fourth quarter now. Now here's Hardy. Edwards defending. The three for Doncic. Rudy Gobert with the rebound. Gobert's got 7 rebounds in the game.
It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Yep, it counts.
Well, they're winning largely because of this guy's play. He has been sensational.
Doncic outside. Doncic knocks in the three.
First three of the half, second of the game. Can he heat up?
Here's Edwards. Good for his 9th make in just 12 shots. That's an even 75% shooting.
Offensively, it's been a perfect quarter for him. He hasn't missed a single shot.
Mavericks trail by 11. Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. And so the ball out of bounds. Gobert touched it last. And the Mavericks call time here. And at this point of the game, getting a break here, important for the teams to regroup. And for the players, this is where you have a chance to get rehydrated with Gatorade. Get ready to play strong to finish off the game. A different look for Dallas. Williams, he's checked in for Morris. And Jones subbed in for Hardy. Timberwolves also changing it up. Karl Anthony Towns checked in for Kyle Anderson. McDaniels comes in for Alexander Walker. And it's Conley in for Shake Milton. Let's check in with our reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, I was able to listen in on what Jason Kidd went over with his team. Now, he tore into his guys. He said, your body language is awful right now. You don't even look like you want to play right now. Should I sub in for you? Where's the drive to win? Guys?
Thanks, David. Jones for three, and he's good on the three ball. Jones has got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. And over 2.5 minutes in the books here in the fourth. And here's Edwards. Outside Conley. Back to Edwards. Gobert with a screen on Hardaway. 4 on the clock. Unloads. And again it's Minnesota.
Boy, you have to like the vision from Karl Anthony Towns. He's got the kind of size necessary to see over the defense.
Doncic left side. It's stolen by Gobert. Now the feed to Edwards.
Oh, that was worth the price of admission. He is a highlight reel unto himself, guys.
That could be a contender for the dunk of the year, I think. Doncic against Conley. Doncic right side. Good. Doncic has got 20.
Well, Luka Doncic relishes the opportunity to control the action, and right now he is cooking the defense.
Mr. Gobert. And a little over 3.5 minutes in the books so far here in the fourth. Towns with three. Out to Conley. Outside, Towns. McDaniels passes to Edwards. Gobert with a screen for Edwards. Good on the three-point shot. Edwards got the lead up to 13 now for the Timberwolves.
And there's no doubt about this one. Playing with a lot of confidence tonight. It's a statement victory for Minnesota.
A beautiful pass doesn't always get you on the highlight reels, but there were some spectacular dishes in this game.
But you know what? It was a team that was in sync and just trusted one another to take the right shots.
And in terms of the season record, this is going to be their 18th win overall. And you know, looking back at all the contributions tonight, it was a really phenomenal all-around game for Anthony Edwards.
Efficient productivity. You love what this guy has given to you on the offensive end.
But the truth is, they've had control of this game.
And I couldn't agree more. What makes it that much more impressive, they're doing it on the road.
26 seconds left to play in the final quarter. The pass to Williams. Here's Lively from downtown. It's hauled in by Karl-Anthony Towns. Now here's Edwards. So it's Minnesota winning this one easy. They came in here and took care of business like they were the home team.
And Kevin, how about the mental toughness that this group showed? They were never rattled at all by the opposing fans.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much, Rudy. This is a defense-first team. You picked it up in the second half. What changes did you make at the half?
I feel like we weren't focused in the first half defensively, and we just have to come back and communicate and just be focused, you know, and that's what we did.
Attention to detail, Rudy. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you for that, David. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, and the rest of our terrific crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. As we present our New Balance Player of the Game, Anthony Edwards.